How happy are you now? You made it.
I guess it cannot be expressed in words. So it's beyond everything that I can attain. It was something like oxygen for me.
Hi, Garvit.
Hello.
How are you here?
I'm quite fine.
So I think I'm just going to take a minute to introduce everybody to Garvit. Right, Garvit is 17 years old, and I think you just cleared NDA, right?
Yes.
And you'll be joining the Indian Army soon, right? And you know, he'll be talking with us about his preparation experience for SSB and NDA, and you know, how did he make it, and you know, who is he, so that you, everybody over here, you know, all of you can get to understand what it takes to prepare to join the Indian Army. Only 0.1% of the people who appear for the entire exam get through it. So there's a huge rigor involved, and Garvit here is a youngster who has been able to, you know, make it through it. So you know, now we'll like ask. I'll be asking Garvit some questions, and you know, hopefully he'll share and drop some pearls of wisdom for all of us. So Garvit, you know, since when have you been preparing? Like, you know, how did you prepare for SSB? And you know, until you prepared for SSB, how was your life? You know, what all were you doing?
Basically, I started preparing for my SSB after I cleared my NDA exam. The result of the exam came about on 15th of December. Within a week, I decided that I would be preparing for my SSB, and I would be giving it with my best, with what I can do my best.
Right.
Like for example, there were many of my friends who tried to give NDA written but could not make through it. So I decided that I would not waste my opportunity, and I would be making the fullest of the opportunity that I got.
Right. Garvit, like, you know, in general, they talk about that there are these OLQs, right? Officer-like qualities. Some people say there are 18, some people say there are 15, 13, whatever, right? You know, what do you think are OLQs?
OLQs are nothing, but they are just the qualities that everyone has. We just need to present it in front of others, like the excesses over there. We just need to show them that we are capable of getting a job, or we are capable of getting recommended from a board, because we deserve the best, simply because we are the best. So OLQs are nothing, but they are the representation of our inner self and our soul in front of others, so that they too are convinced that yes, we are the best.
Okay, and like you say, matlab before the NDA, like how many, like you know, typically, like how much did you prepare for it? Did you like 12th boards ke pehle, you know, kuch alag se, did you know, like spend any, did you get any coaching for anything? You know, NDA ke liye, how did you prepare? Like how was that for you?
For written exam, I actually did not prepare for anything. Like I was doing for my JEE examination, which basically led me to a mass that I could score 145 in the written examination. So preparing for mathematics was not a issue for me, but I lagged behind in social science and GK because I was not in touch with that.
Okay.
So I tried to complete my history, that is for 6th to 10th NCERT. I did that before the examination. I also did a few chapters of biology, class 9th and 10th. So it helped me a lot.
So like, you know, you just got through your board exams for 12th standard, right? And you just mentioned that, you know, you also prepared, you were looking to prepare for JEE as well, you know. Like, why did you not join engineering, you know? Why did you not pursue engineering? And, you know, did you get into any good colleges?
Actually, I did not make it into quite good colleges, but I decided that after getting recommended from my SSB, I decided that I would be going for the NDA only. So I dropped the option of JEE. So my ultimate goal shifted from JEE to NDA only.
Okay. Jaise, you know, like, so you mentioned that there were all these friends of yours, you know, who were also preparing for NDA. Why did they not make it? You know, unse baad mein baat hui to, you know, were you able to, you know, perceive or understand ki yaar unka kyun nahi hua, and why did you make it?
It was basically hard work. They were preparing for NDA, but I prepared for JEE. That is about, I guess, one or two steps ahead of that. So basically, preparing for something tougher led me to getting good at a lower.
So, like, would you say that you were good at mathematics?
I was quite good.
So you're still good at mathematics. So you enjoy maths and everything.
I enjoyed maths.
Okay, awesome. So, like, you know, now shifting to the SSB preparation, right? How, like, so you said that, you know, after you qualified for your NDA, you decided, you know, now you will prepare for SSB. So, and I think you prepared with Colonel Sharma only, you know, like, of the future of for Army Officers Academy. So, you know, how is that for you? Like, you know, what was the SSB preparation like for you? What did you do? How did you go about it? You know, 5 days preparation, how is that for you?
Firstly, I would like to thank Colonel Rajiv Sharma because he basically made a mindset out of me that how to prepare and how to present ourselves in front of be it a GTO, be it the interviewing officer, or how to show our mentality in psycho test. So he helped me a lot, he guided me, he motivated me, he made the best out of me. He truly deserves that. It's not my victory, it's his victory. He showed me the path, he motivated me, he led me to my success. Now coming upon my SSB preparation, I would like to say that I was aimless in the beginning.
Right.
But then I came in contact with Colonel Rajiv Sharma. He made a mindset that we must be thinking positive only. Like an officer, what basically is an officer? It's the one who can come out of any situation with his wits or by controlling his temper, basically, like being calm. It's the only success that it's the only thing that brings success. So Colonel Sharma helped me a lot how to present myself, how to be how to basically impress. I would like to use the term impress because
Okay. It's
the only thing that people think we must be impressing the XSR, like the interviewing officer or the GTO.
Right. Awesome. Yeah. You know, but like, so let's say before the, you know, for the SSB preparation, let's say, you know, so you talked about, you know, what is an army officer, and you mentioned that an army officer is just a person, you know, who's an optimist, who can come out of, you know, any situation by just thinking about the most obvious, right, logical thing to do, right? Do you think, so, you know, by that logic, do you think everybody can think like that?
No, not everyone can think like that, but sometimes it may change when the situation demands. Like, it can be anything. You can take an example, like someone is sad that he has not made it to a good college. Be it APJ Abdul Kalam, he could not make through his SSB. But on his file, after being the President of India, when he checked his file, what he saw was the child is made for something better than this. So it's basically deserving, and God has planned something better for us.
So to understand, you know, what you're trying to say here, so the question here is that, you know, can everybody think rationally and, you know, ultimately become an army officer? Right. So, and what I've been able to understand from your answer is that, you know, not everybody. So you started it out with not everybody. But I think, you know, what you mean to say here is that almost everybody has their rationale, but it fits in some or the other way. Right. Is that what you're trying to say? Or, you know, are you trying to say something else? Would you like to elaborate a little bit more?
Yes. It's basically like everyone has an officer inside them, but not everyone is able to portray it when it is required.
Okay. So would you say that, you know, preparing for SSB is the process of nurturing the officer within you?
Yes. It's first realizing that what qualities do I possess, and then representing it in front of others, showing it that you are capable enough that you can hold a good position and have a good you can represent yourself, and you can represent an entire country behind you. You basically have those guts. You basically have the confidence that, yes, I can. Yes, I can do it. Either by just basic support or by complete support.
Okay. That is very well said, I think. You know, that said, so one of the fundamentals of Future Army Officers Academy, right, is that we provide everybody with the one-on-one coaching, you know. जब कर्ण शर्मा के साथ में प्रिपेयर करते हो तो यू नो लाइक ऐसा नहीं होता कि जनरल में 30 बच्चों की क्लास है या 6 बच्चों की क्लास है, हर एक क्लास हमारी, एक बच्चा और एक आप होता है, यू नो, यू हैव एक्सपीरियंस दैट. सो डू यू थिंक दैट्स लाइक दैट इज द बेस्ट एंड द मोस्ट परफेक्ट वे टू प्रिपेयर फॉर SSB? बिकॉज यू नो आपकी कमियाँ अगर आपका यू नो वन ऑन वन में पकड़ी जा सकती है, ऐसे तो यू नो झुंड में तो पता भी नहीं लगता कि आपके अंदर कमियाँ क्या है. डू यू थिंक दैट इज यू नो सो वन ऑन वन इज लाइक अ वेरी एडवांटेजियस सेटअप to prepare for SSB?
Yes, it is the best. Because when you are in a class of 10 or 20, you do not come to know about your loopholes. Like, you are not able to figure it out, or
right.
you may be shy enough that you don't ask your loopholes in
right,
front
right,
of the
right.
class. So, if it is about like one-to-one, then there is no shyness. There is only teacher and you.
Awesome, yeah. So, you know, like, you talked about loopholes. You know, let's get a little, you know, eased out over here. Help me, you know, understand, you know, what was one of your major loopholes? Like, jo ki na SSB ke pehle pata nahi tha. And kyunki Colonel Sharma ke saath baithe to unhone, you know, he was able to help you identify one of some of the loopholes in yourself, you know, while you were preparing. And once you figured out, you were like, ah, and you know, that contributed. So what were some of your loopholes that you overcame before your SSB preparation?
The biggest loophole that I still remember is I was asked to make a in WAT I was asked to make a sentence from word murder. So I just thought in a negative way, and what I was corrected was he said that you must eradicate the negativeness out of it. So it must be like that police work hard to eradicate murder throughout the country. So thinking murder is a negative word,
right.
but making positive out of it is something that only can be told in one-to-one.
You know, like, since you know, adding on to your experience, since I observe a lot of these students, you know, who come at the Future Army Officers Academy, and I, you know, observe, you know, Colonel Sharma, you know, spending like starting from 7:30 in the morning until night 12:30, I've noticed that, you know, from outside, like, you know, their general advice is that, you know, you have to be a positive person, you know, you have to be able to put a positive spin to it, right? And you have to be able to, you have to portray the fact that you're an optimist, right? Essentially, that's what this is more or less about. Kyunki itne stress mein, koi negative pessimist person, you know, how will they cope through it, right? But what is the process, you know? Like, jaise unhone aapko bataya, you know, that is how you form this sentence. But psychologically, you know, deep within your brain, thoda sa fundamental level pe, you know, how, you know, do you see that change in your general perception of things as well?
Repeatedly बार बार एक ही चीज सुनेंगे तो दिमाग में तो बैठ जाएगी. So it's like I made mistakes, he corrected me each and every time I made a mistake. He made me realize what basically was my mistake, which helped me overcome it, not in just one go, but repeated. बार बार मारा उन्होंने तो समझ ही आ गया.
अरे नहीं नहीं मारा नहीं, मतलब मारते नहीं है ना, like it's not
physically.
It's
basically he struck it in my mind.
Right.
दिमाग में बार बार knock knock.
Right. यार ये तो like, you know, this is pretty nice, you know. इसके अलावा anything outside of, you know, being positive, what were the other, you know, loopholes that you had?
Firstly, I lacked a little bit of confidence, like speaking in public. So first day only, he asked me to introduce myself, and it did not go quite well. So he told me that I must be confident enough to speak in public gatherings too.
Right.
So it helped me a lot to build my confidence. It helped me a lot to think in a way that an officer can only think.
So, you know, like, that's very interesting. You know, that's not just your problem, I would say that, you know, that's like a general fundamental problem for anybody wanting to join the Indian Army. Confidence, right? So, you know, like, you mentioned that you were not able to do it. And of course, you, one other thing that you just mentioned was that practice makes perfect. You know, you practiced out day in and day out with him, and, you know, you were able to solve for it. You know, anything outside of practice, you know, anything that you tell yourself mentally ki nahi yaar, you know, like anything you do in order to be more confident?
It's determination, I would like to say that. I was determined that I have to go for NDA only. So I knew my ultimate goal is getting a uniform. So it was something like oxygen for me. So I had to do that. So building confidence was a necessity at that time. So I had to get through all the procedures over there. I needed to make it into NDA. It was my ultimate thought, which helped me a lot in clearing NDA, be it SSB or be it written examination. So,
how happy are you now, you know, that you've made it into the NDA?
I guess it cannot be expressed in words. So it's beyond everything that I can attain. Like listening, sir, from someone who is the ones who are preparing for NDA, they generally call their senior as sir. So listening, sir, from someone whom you don't know is the utmost level of pleasure you can ever experience in your life.
Right. That is, you know, like, that must be very inspiring for people who are right now, you know, seeing this video and you know, this is on YouTube, so it's pre-recorded, but I'm pretty sure if I was an aspirant for Indian Army right now, I'd feel very inspired listening to that coming from your mouth. That's really, really remarkable. Help me understand, you know, there is this general myth that, you know, people who are very fit, na thoda sa matlab gym jaate hain aur thode body shoddy bana lete hain, unko lagta hai ki, you know, hum to fit ho gaye to hum to Indian Army mein chale hi jayenge. Do you think that's true? Aisa hota hai kya? But what about that mentality? How would you like
it's
to tell them?
It's truly a myth, because there were many bodybuilders in my SSB, but they could not make through it. It's not the test of physical strength, it's just a personality test. If you are, if you can portray yourself, you can surely make it into it. Even after six pack abs and 16 inches of dholas,
yeah,
you can't make it.
Dole se koi fayda nahi hai, right? Dole se koi fayda nahi hai. And you know, so help me understand this aspect. So what was your, you know, like the final interview ke time mein, there are all these stories ki, you know, mere final interviewer ne mujhse ye pucha and everything. I've, because you know, I've seen all these people who have joined the Indian Army, everybody has a interview story, you know, ki interview mein this was the question and this is how I answered that question, you know, andar pata hota hai ki ye kara tha isliye hua, right? So what is that, you know, what is your interview story?
The interviewing officer asked me, why do you want to join defense forces, basically. So my straight away answer was, sir, I need that uniform at any cost, be it anything. I can sacrifice each and everything just to get into that uniform. And then he just said, would you be fit for the uniform? So I answered that, sir, you just give me the uniform, I'll fit into that myself only. I'll develop the qualities, be it fitting through physical fitness, I'll gain weight, I'll make dollars and each and everything to look perfect for that uniform.
Right.
I just need it at that moment.
Right. So according to you, it was your, you know, ruthless, you know, conviction that helped you, you know, convince the interviewing officer of your qualities and everything. Help me, you know, like, again, like, you know, this is, I'll take a specific GTO question. GTO ke baare mein na baat karna thoda mushkil hota hai. To GTO mein batao yaar ki, what is a general advice to clear GTO, to good at GTO tasks, right? Thoda sa physical hota hai, you know, thoda psychological hota hai, how you choose your team, how you perform your task. It's a test of intelligence, fitness, and, you know, overall personality. But you know, it is the less talked about aspect of SSB, because na koi samajh nahi pata hai. Only people who have gone for it can understand the GTO task, right? So yaar, you know, help people understand about, you know, what is GTO, and agar koi simple, you know, what would be the simple advice and what would be the deep advice to clear the GTO test, and how did you do it?
For GTO, you must have good stamina, because it's not really necessary, but if you have a good stamina, you have got a plus point over the others. Like score in individual obstacles, if you score a higher number of marks, then it increases your chance of being selected or being recommended from the SSB. But it's not like hard and fast rule to have a good stamina or to be fit.
I'll block you there. You know, when you say fit, what you mean is, you know, you don't have to be bulky, muscular. What you mean by fit is, you know, what you mean to say is, you know, somebody who can run well, you know, somebody who's not like fat or obese. Or, you know, somebody who is not like, just say, generally unfit. What you mean to say is not being unfit and being decently fit as an individual, right?
Being fit is being able to run around kilometer or 1.5 kilometer, or like being able to perform their daily task, or like not being too obese, overweight, but being decently fit is required.
Right, right. So yeah, you were saying that, you know, general advice, you know, I blocked you in between, you should continue. And you were mentioning that, you know, you just have to be generally fit and stamina is an advantage. What else?
For speaking part, like group planning exercise or group discussion, you must be bold enough to put your point in front of everyone without hesitation. It is the only thing that can lead you to success. If you are not able to express yourself or put your point, then how would the other person know what you really think or what you really want to tell others, or what is your point of view, basically. So you must be bold enough to put your point. Secondly, you must be confident while speaking. Like, for example, you are kuch bola humne and the other person did not get it.
Yeah.
So it's our fault, not
yeah.
his fault. Not his fault.
Correct.
So it also depends how you convince others that what you are speaking is true or like it's the best version to put others' point of view to.
So, you know, just to put a structure around what you said, I think, you know, what you're trying to communicate is key. You have to get a buy-in from everybody who's a part of your team so that together, when you work as a unit, everybody has the similar level of conviction at achieving, you know, whatever the command you're sharing, right? You know, that's what you're trying to communicate. So, you know, would it be fair to say that, you know, the GTO exam is an exam of how you would actually most likely act if you were in the war zone or in the field?
Yes, it is basically a portrait that how would you act like if you are in a dangerous situation. The group planning exercise was basically about the same. We were given about 5 to 6 problem and we had to solve it with the resources available to us.
Right.
So it's basically how we use the limited resources to complete a task or to basically accomplish a mission.
Right.
So it's just we have to think like an officer, not like a candidate or so.
Okay.
We have to fit in the situation like, yes, I am the officer, I am given this task, how would I accomplish it?
Right. That is pretty, you know, I think that is very solid advice. That is very basic advice. You know, what is the worst advice that you got for SSB? You know, like the general, you know, of all the affine, you know, ek bahut zyada general vague advice bhi market mein chalta hai, like, you know, people are sharing ki aisa kar lo, right, whatnot. So what do you think is that is one of these things that everybody who's preparing for SSB believes, but jab SSB dene jaate to pata lagta hai aisa kuch nahi hai. You know, what is one of those things that is a myth about SSB?
Recommendation rate is low. First myth. Second myth, there are many selection centers like be it Allahabad, be it Gandhinagar. They are called as rejection centers.
Right.
But the candidates are recommended from there too. So
right.
Nothing is impossible. You can make through it if you are determined towards the goal.
Awesome. What is really amazing, you know, that you are somebody who's right now, who's made into it, you know, the NDA during the type of coronavirus, right? So, you know, I think viewers, you know, people who are right now going to appear for their NDA, you know, SSB exams might want to know, yaar, what are the special things to take care of? Because, you know, there's a lot of confusion. They want to keep themselves safe and everything, right? And kuch guidelines bhi diya hai ki coronavirus ka 72 hours test and everything. So do you want to just like, you know, kind of give us like what are the new additional things that you had to take care of while attempting SSB during COVID-19?
It was basically that social distancing was of utmost importance. Then there were a lot of problems like we were at a distance, so we had to be loud enough that other person is able to hear us.
Right.
It was the only thing that I remember I had to take care of specially.
Acha. Okay. And any other test, any other reports that you had to carry, you know, for the exam, you know, for SSB?
RT-PCR negative was must to be taken during the SSB in COVID times.
What is RT-PCR? Do you want to help, you know, people who are kind of, you know, viewing this, understand what is it, kahan se karate hain, aur kya hota hai ye?
It's basically the COVID test, like from where they take swabs through our nose and through our throat.
Okay.
It is accurate test. There is also another test, rapid test, which the result are not up to the mark.
Okay.
So RT-PCR is the best to be taken.
So what you have to do before the exam is that, you know, you have to take an RT-PCR test clearance report before you go for SSB, and while during SSB you have to practice COVID-19. So now this change is that SSB mein jaane ke liye thoda zor se bolna bhi aana chahiye, right? During COVID-19, and you have to get that test up.
Yes. We need to take the RT-PCR negative report, and then even after that, we were made to sit at a distance of about 3 feet.
Okay.
We must have a good vocal strength.
Good vocal strength. That is important, yeah. So confidence, vocal strength, you know, public speaking, sab adds up. Everything adds up and, you know, makes it work. Generally, skill to chahiye to become an army. So, you know, now that you spent 5 days there, you know, how is it like, you know, वैसे 5 days होते कैसे यार वहाँ पे, मतलब 5 days, you know, how are you feeling during the interview?
मतलब इंटर तक 5 दिन कम नहीं कर गए. It's like we came yesterday only, and the best experience you can ever get through those 5 days. be it through sports, basketball, football, cricket, volleyball, and number of sports.
Right.
Then interaction through candidates from various states and from distant places. You get to know about their culture, you get to know about their languages, you get to know about something that they only know or like we can never ever think of.
Right.
We come to know about, like I came to know about various officers who were recommended from those boards and who became a glamour.
Who became like, you know, very well-known people.
Yes, they became eminent personalities.
Okay, okay. Who were those like, you know, people? Like, just
like I came to know about stories of Major Somnath Sharma and I do not exactly remember the name of other one, but it was somewhat like Albert.
Okay.
He was posted in Eastern region and he cut off around 11 Chinese.
Wow. This is very nice. Now you've made it to, you know, NDA. When did you receive, you know, your selection and, you know, what rank and everything did you get into it?
All India rank in merit was 150.
Okay.
And I got my joining letter on, I guess, 14th or 15th of October.
Mm-hmm.
And the reporting date is 19th of October 2020.
19th of October 2020. So, you know, you're about to go and join the Indian Army very soon. Right, this is real nice. Like, how did you feel when you get the reporting letter? मतलब जब आया पहली बार, you know, email पे आता चिट्ठी आती है.
It basically came on the online portal of joinindianarmy.com.
Right.
So it also took a lot of patience. It came one by one, and waiting till my joining letter was a big issue for me.
Okay.
Like, it took around 20 to 25 days to get that letter.
Right.
So. I cannot express that happiness.
Okay, again.
It's basically getting each and everything you wanted to attain in your life.
Right, right. You know, so you join, so you'll be joining and you'll be going in for training and everything. Right, do you think you'll miss anything, you know, that normal college kids will get to experience?
No, nothing.
We
get each and everything over there and better facilities are present over there.
Better facilities are definitely better. What do you plan to buy with the first salary that you get as an Indian Army officer?
I haven't thought of about it yet, but it may be either a phone,
right,
or maybe something, shoes or something else.
How much role do you think luck played in your becoming an Indian Army officer? What all had to go right so that you could get to, you know, experience the joy of getting to know that one day you get to serve Indian Army? What all, like, you know, how much luck was involved in your selection?
Little bit of luck was involved because during the COVID times I was recommended not to go to the SSB because due to high risk of being infected over there, but I chose to go. It was a luck factor, I think, that played major role. Then during the recommendations there were many candidates who did quite well and whom we were expecting that they too would be clearing the SSB, but some of them did not make it, so luck factor came there too.
Right. And, you know, like, are there any people in your family who have been in the Indian Army before, and, you know, did you get any guidance through that?
My maternal grandfather was in Army. He's a retired captain. He too played a major role in guiding me. My maternal uncles, they are in Army, retired colonel. They also motivated me a lot.
Right. That is really cool to know, yaar. You know, in general, outside of, so, you know, to all the people who are still in their 12th standard right now, you know, any parting message for them, you know, anything that you'd like to tell them, you know, when they're aspiring for Indian Army, about how to go about it?
Go ahead in a positive way, never be depressed, or like, if you are not able to make it through it in first attempt, there are many more attempts left to you. You must be confident enough that if you have practiced well, if you are prepared well, then you are definitely gonna rock, be it the SSB or be it the written part. Don't worry about being recommended. Enjoy the 5 days that you spent over there because you won't get that time back again. So for the written, as far as it is concerned, you must be scoring good in mathematics and then you must be well prepared for the SST and GK part.
Right. Would you suggest to people who, you know, crack the written and get into for the SSB, to, you know, would you suggest them, you know, coaching is a beneficial thing for them. Would you say that?
Yes, coaching is quite beneficial because it tells you that where you are lagging or where you can improve or where you should improve.
Right.
So it provides you basically a positive mindset. It helps you portray yourself in a better way. It basically changes you entirely.
So we have a strong recommendation for you, you know, for people who are trying to make it to the SSB, you know, to take a coaching, right, ultimately. And, you know, that is a beneficial thing if they go to the right people for it, right?
Yes, I think
awesome.
That coaching is a must to crack SSB.
Awesome. You know, how long do you plan? You know, like, so you're joining, you know, for viewers, would you like to tell, you know, what is your first rank going to be, you know, and everything? Would you want to, like, just say it for the first time so that, you know, people who are listening this can feel pride? Can express, you know, you can get to expect, you know, feel your pride a little bit.
I would be joining as flying officer.
You'd
so
be joining as flying officer. Do you want to state your full name? What will it be
flying
when you join?
Flying officer Garvit Sharma.
Flying officer Garvit Sharma, right? After the training, you will be flying officer Garvit Sharma, and you're going on for training at 19th. That's really remarkable, right, Garvit? I think it has been a pleasure, total pleasure to talk to you. I believe everybody who's listening to this has something that they can take away and implement. And, you know, underneath this video, we'll most likely share Future Army Officer Academy, you know, links in the video. Our website is faossb.com, and, you know, our main mentor is Colonel Radhvi Sharma. He takes one-on-one coaching, and like you just heard Garvit, he was able to, you know, really benefit out of the coaching with him. And any of you, you know, we have limited slots every month, so if you'd like to, you know, take coaching and, you know, prepare for your SSB exams, definitely drop in a message and, you know, book your free assessment call with Colonel Sharma. Thank you, Garvit. Thanks a lot. Thanks for your time. Enjoyed talking to you. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Hope you found it useful. Then don't forget to like, share and subscribe.